And Action 7 News reporter Dominic Garcia continues our team coverage.
You talked to a local Haitian group that still has ties to the area, and they're already raising money.
Right, and they've been talking to family members, just hearing about that devastation that's happening in that country. And with such a close connection, this group is very motivated to take action. It's hard to find the words that describe the devastation.
It was like an atom bomb, they said. It was incredible.
Louis St. Lo is from Haiti and still has family there.
It happened at 4:15. In Haiti, we have three sessions of school. So we still had a session of school at 4:15. And all those schools, children in school, and in the schools, it's just unbelievable. We've had three family houses totally destroyed. They were very well constructed. So it just goes to show you the power of this earthquake.
His brother was trapped in a house but managed to get out. Others couldn't escape the destruction.
I've had a cousin that wasn't able to get out of the house when the house collapsed. So she's with God now.
It's unbearable to watch, but it spurred action. Lewis is part of a group called Hands of the Caribbean. They're raising money for heavy machinery to clear debris, water purification, even nutritional packets.
The personal knowledge of Haiti, we know who needs the help, who to go to, who the leaders are, the neighborhood leaders, the church leaders.
They're hoping to streamline aid and rush it to those who need it most. It will be the first step in what will be a very long road to recovery. And that group is also accepting donations of toiletries like soap, toothpaste, and toothbrushes. Lewis says they plan on traveling to Haiti Monday or on Tuesday to start handing out that aid. Back to you.
If you're interested in donating to the Hands of the Caribbean, the number is 505-922-5550.